In Aramark, the facilitator and executive director of African Network for Environment and Economic Justice, Reverend David Ugolo, said the interactive session was organized by leaders of various non-governmental organizations in Edo State to engage various candidates in their roadmap and blueprints for Edo people ahead of the election. Reverend Ugolo said the crux of the program is to cross-fertilize ideas on critical issues affecting the people, pointing out that the interactive session will form the basis for an agreement that must be honored if candidate emerges winner for the forthcoming election.
We will not use this platform to support any candidate. We want to create a platform where if you are alone, you won't be able to have this platform to reach out to the candidate. But when we all come together, the candidate will respect that common voice. That is the spirit behind this platform. Two sides need to put their views and perspective on the table, so that at the end of the election, we'll be able to hold accountable whoever that eventually wins the election.
Other speakers at the event, who include Austin Osaku, Reverend Olu Martins, and Barrister Abraham Obiawe, said the interactive section is more of a covenant than just a mere talk. They said Network of Civil Society Organizations of Nigeria will team up with concerned citizens of the state to hold any candidate who wins the election accountable to their electionary promises, adding that failure to do the needful by the eventual winner will be visited with massive protests.
When government decides that it will practice an oligarchy instead of a democracy, it falls back on us. So the government cannot give you security. So if you are to become governor, if and when you become governor, we want to know those things you will do differently.
We want a governor, like the professor said, a governor that will be accountable to the people, that will live out the true creed of Abraham Lincoln's definition of democracy.
After all issues raised by participants on reasons behind Godwin Obaseki's aspiration and what he has on board to improve the socio-economic fortunes of Edo people if elected as governor, the APC governorship hopeful Mr. Godwin Obaseki said he has been the brain behind the developmental strides of the current governor in the past 7 years and expressed optimism of improving and bringing innovative ideas to boost investment, create employment, standard educational practice, and engage restive youths in meaningful ventures.
Edo is an anchor grower state for palm, for rubber, for cassava, for rice. Education does not mean a university degree. Education should mean you being able to do something for yourself.
The iterative section is expected to feature other governorship candidates before the election dates. Wellington Akodeja reporting.